Hello and welcome to another episode of Stable Diffusion Experimental. Today we'll be looking at IC Light, something that just came out a few days ago and it's oh so close to be actually production ready, and hopefully it will be soon. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. What is IC Light? Well, long story short, IC Light is a new way to relight an image. In this example, you can see that we're starting from the image on the left and getting the image on the right. It's been completely relit by the mask over here. Now, this mask is being created through these nodes, but you can also import a mask of your choosing that you created, for example, by using Photoshop. Right now, we have two different implementations of IC Light inside of comfyui and some implementations of it in Automatic 11.11 as well. And all of them are able to relight an image by using a mask as a source or by using both a background and a light or just the background. So today we're going to take a look at two different workflows. One for the background and one for just a single light. But first, what is IC Light? Well, IC Light is brought to you by none other than the dev that brought you ControlNet. And in its native implementation, it can work on Gradio or on Automatic 11.11, and it's been ported to comfyui as well. And as you can see, it's a powerful tool to relight an image. Here on the GitHub, you can see a lot of these examples. And if you want to take a look at the GitHub yourselves, you will be able to find the link in the description below. Now, another really cool thing about it is that by relighting a single image multiple times, you can combine all of these images and create a normal map. Now, I'm sure this is invaluable to those of you who like normal map control nets, but also to 3D artists out there who are more used to using normal maps when compared to us generative AI people. And to me, this is really insane, because one thing that I've been missing a lot in generative AI is the ability to work with normal maps. I think that they're much better than depth maps, at least when light is concerned. But how do we install and use all these goodies? Well, as I said before, right now for comfyui, there's two different projects being developed, and you'll be able to find the links in the description below for both of them. But the one that I'm going to use today is the one by Kijai, or at least I hope that I pronounced that correctly. Now, this node suite is being updated constantly and every few hours. So the one you will end up downloading might be slightly different from the one that I'm using today, but the overall inner workings should be the same. The first thing you want to do is go over to the green button for code here and copy the GitHub link. Then go over to your comfyui folder, comfyui, custom nodes, and then right click, open in terminal, and write down git clone and paste the link to the GitHub repo. And press enter. Now, in my case, obviously, I already have it installed, so I've got an error, but in your case, it's going to download the repository. If you don't want to go with the git clone method, you can always import this workflow by dragging and dropping this image here inside of your comfyui instance and then install missing custom nodes by using the comfyui manager. The next thing we're going to need is some models from Hugging Face. So we're going to click on this link here, and we are going to have three models here. Now, in the comfyui version, only these two, these first two, are supported, the FBC and the FC versions. The FBC is the one for backgrounds, and the FC one is the one for the light as a mask. So we're going to download both of them, and we are going to place them in the models unit folder. Now, it's really important that you place it in the unit folder. Once you have downloaded all the models needed, you can import one or two workflows from the GitHub. This one, for example, is the one for relighting via a mask. Now, I'm going to separate all of what's happening here so that you can get a better understanding of what's going on. Okay, that's better. That's a little bit more understandable. So what's happening is we are loading a checkpoint, and for now, IC Light only works with 1.5. So we are loading either Photon in this case, or we can also work with some other models that work as well. So like Natural Scene. Then we have the usual clip text and code nodes, one for positive prompt on the top and one for negative prompt on the bottom. And then moving in a little bit closer, on the top, we have a load and apply IC Light node. This node sources model from your unit folder. And depending on the workflow that you want to use, either the one for the light via mask or the one with the background influencing the overall lighting, you want to select either FC in the first case or FBC in the background case. So in this case, we're going to select FC. The model that's going through the load and apply IC light is ending up in the case sampler. Then, a bit further down, we have an IC light conditioning node. This node needs some different inputs. We've got a positive and negative inputs coming in from the positive and negative prompt. We have a VAE coming in from the model, and we have some foreground and optional background inputs. In this case, since we're using the model for the relighting with just the mask that's acting as a light source, we don't have the optional background, we only have the foreground. Let's take a look at what's happening in the foreground. For the foreground, which basically in this case is the whole picture since we don't have a new background, we are loading an image with a load image node. Then we are resizing it and we are encoding it. Since the IC light conditioning node only accepts latent as inputs, we have to encode it. Now, I've actually asked why, because I was getting an error. It only accepts latent and not images. And I was told by the dev that they switched it from images to latents because it would run out of memory on large batches. So this way, it wouldn't run out of memory. So now that we have everything that we need inside the IC light conditioning node, the only thing that's missing is a multiplier. I will show you what the multiplier does, but for now, let's keep it at the default value of 0.182. Now, as you can see, we have three outputs from the IC light conditioning node. We have positive and negative, those are the prompts, and we have a latent. But we are not using that latent in the case sampler. Instead, we are using another latent. And the latent that we are using in the case sampler comes from an encode mask. The mask is created from the dimensions of the image that we are loading and resizing. So in our case, that's 512 by 640. And then it's shaped by selecting a shape, in our case, a circle, square, or triangle. And then by selecting a location for positioning of the light source and a shape width and shape height. So in our case, the location is 264, which is basically the center of the frame. And you can see that the light here is at the center of the x-axis. Then the location for y is 338, and you can see that it's a bit slightly down from the center since this whole height is 640. And then it's very narrow and very tall, and that's reflected in this shape width, which is very tiny, it's 196, and a shape height of 454. Then we have some settings for grow mask with blur so that it's not a solid circle. And then we have a remap mask range, and what this basically does, it just remaps the range from black to white. In our case, it's starting from zero, which is pure black, but it's ending at 0.65, which is not pure white. Pure white would be one. So in this case, the light's not too harsh, but if we go all the way up to one and hit Q prompt again, we can see how the light's a lot harsher. So the remap mask range basically controls the intensity of the light. And then let's analyze the case sampler. As I was saying, the latent is sourced from the mask that's been encoded as an image. And the way all this works, I think so because of an earlier version of this node suit that was using instruct pix to pix instead of a proper IC light conditioning node, is that this IC light conditioning node is basically a front end of sorts, and behind it there's an instruct pix to pix workflow. So instead of projecting the light source on top of the original image, is doing the opposite. It's starting off from the encoded image of the light, and then it's projecting the original image on top of that. Now, for the case sampler values, we want to use a good number of steps. In this case, that's 25. I've tested this with a CFG range from 2 to 3, and it works fine in all of my testings. And for sampler name, I've tested it with Euler, DPM++, it all works. And for scheduler, I've tried it with a simple DDIM, Keras, it all works. So you can just default back to Keras or normal and it all works fine. Now the last thing that we need to look at is the multiplier. Let's see how the multiplier works by going down all the way to 0.05, and you can see that the image is a lot undercooked. Now let's go to 0.1 and the image starts to get right. Let's go all the way up to 0.25, and the image is a little bit overcooked. Now, this might not be as apparent with this kind of light source, but you will see with the background workflow that the multiplier is really important. Now, another way that you can influence results here is by working on the positive prompt field. Now we have spotlight on face. If I remove on face, for example, and just leave spotlight, you can see that the light's not good at all. So directing the light helps a lot. If I put beauty dish from above, for example, we can get some direction from the light as well by maintaining the original mask, but giving it a direction of sorts. Now, you would need to be kind of familiar with lighting terms. Being a photographer, it kind of comes easy to me, but Really, there's not many terms out there. I think you would be happy with Beauty Dish, Softbox, Spotlight, and maybe a few others like Snoot Light. But since trying to draw up a mask with a node is kind of difficult, at least to visualize in your mind's eye, let's find another way to do that. What you could do instead of using a Create Shape Mask node is just create a mask inside of Photoshop, for example, and then loading it into the workflow. Or you could just right-click on the source image, select Open in Mask Editor, and then paint on the image where you want the light to be. So let's say we want to have a softbox from above kind of effect. We're going to select everything up to the cheekbones and then some of the shoulders. We're going to save to node, and then we're going to change the positive prompt to softbox from above. And then we want to connect the mask from the load image node into the grow mask with blur. So we are bypassing the create shape mask now. Then we maybe want to up the max value from the remap mask range in order to get a bit of a more powerful light. So let's go with 0.85, for example, and let's hit cue prompt. And there you can see that we got the light exactly where we wanted it to be. Now that may be a bit too powerful, so let's go down to 0.7 and see what happens. And that's way better. So all in all, as you can see, this workflow for relighting a single subject or multiple subjects really from a single light source, it works really, really well. It can work with people, it can work with objects, it can work with pretty much anything. So I'm quite happy with it. But let's now switch to the background influence relighting. And that's the reason why I think that IC light is still quite experimental and it's not quite production ready yet. But let's switch over to this workflow now. You can find it in the description below. This is the polished version of the workflow that we built together in my latest live. And you can use it either by using it all or just by switching off this group on the left and then plugging in this load image node here, and this just acts as a standalone. But if you're interested about knowing how all of this works in detail, you'll have a link in the description below to my latest live. But what it basically does is it just starts from a few renders in Blender for poses and then generates a picture for a fashion editorial based on style for the style of image that we want to create, the item of clothing that we want to generate on top of the model, the attention mask for where that item of clothing should be generated on top of the render, and the face of the model that we want to have throughout all of the fashion editorial. And the next step, at least in my live stream video, was to relight the whole picture with a red background, so overall a very reddish light. But we can use it as well just to relight and re-background this picture as well. Now, the way that IC light works with background is that it can either work with background only or with background and a mask for light. So you can apply all the same principles that you just applied in the previous workflow and apply it here, but you have to keep two things in mind. One is that we need the FPC model here in the load and apply IC light node. So before we were using the FC model, now we have to use the FPC model. And the other thing that you have to be wary of is that the background is color casting a lot on the subject. Let me show you what I mean. In this picture, the overall lighting is kind of well preserved. We can see that the model has understood that the light is coming from over here. So if you take a look at the original light here in top left corner, you can see that it was completely different. And now it comes from where the light source should be. But the color cast on both the body and the face is way too much. The way it's acting, it looks like the greens are used as a light source as well. And while that happens in reality, because light bounces off from grass and trees as well, it's not as pronounced. Something like this basically never happens. Now, if I switch the image to a grid of neon lights, something like this result here on the right might seem natural to you. And it would be kind of natural because with neon lights, everything is affected a lot. So you might be tempted to think that it was just a matter of that one picture. But if we bring up a photo of some clouds in the sky, you can see what I mean here. There is just no way that the blue sky is casting so much color on top of anyone's face. So in my experience, it works really best with toned down backgrounds or really specific backgrounds, such as neon lights, for example, as we've seen, or kind of regular backgrounds like gray backgrounds and white backgrounds. But if you want to generate something with a background that has a lot of color in it, then be prepared to have a lot of color cast on top of the subject, which I personally don't like. Now, it could very well be a matter of settings. Like over here, the multiplier might need to be a lot lower. So for example, 0.12. But as you can see, yeah, the color cast issue is getting better, but the overall picture is a lot undercooked. In my testing, I've found that the multiplier works best between 0.15 and 0.2, so it can't really be that. So, all in all, while I believe that the background relight is a bit scuffed right now and it's not production ready at all, what I think is production ready is Relight for products. Now, in this example, we are generating the product, but what you could do is just plug in a real product here. But what this is doing is it's basically starting from an already existing image of a product and then apply a mask of our choosing. In our case, the mask has been generated inside of Photoshop, effortlessly really. This is just a brush stroke. And then it's relighting the product image completely from scratch. So in my opinion, if you wanted to go with the background replacing route, what you could do is just create a different background with another workflow, for example, the one that we used a few weeks ago for replacing backgrounds, and then relight it completely. Because one of the weaknesses of any workflow that replaces background is that the lighting most of the times is not taken into consideration. With this IC light, you can just relight the whole picture completely from scratch. And that way you could have consistent lighting throughout all of the pictures. So today we didn't build any workflow from scratch because these two workflows are basically plug and play. You don't have to do a lot with them and the overall structure is pretty fixed. There's no reason why you would change anything in these workflows. The overall structure of the IC light node suits is fixed. So what you could do is just append other stuff at the beginning of the workflow, like in my case where I was generating models and then relighting them, or generating products and then relighting them, or start from an already existing product and then relight them. But yeah, overall I think this is an incredibly powerful tool and I'm really really happy that we finally have something like this that I've been wanting for quite a while now, and I think that this is one of the steps in the right directions that we are taking in order to tame the chaos that is inherent to generating with AI, both in terms of what we can produce with it and in terms of what we can tell clients that we can achieve. So that's going to be all for today. I hope you had some fun with it and you learned something. My name is Andrea Baioni. You can find me on Instagram at risunobushi or on the web at andreabaioni.com. If you liked this video, remember to like and subscribe as it helps a lot with the channel, and I'll be seeing you next week.